Hey guys, welcome on in. It's time for 30 Books in 30 Weeks. I was just finishing up my reading before I head into some meetings this afternoon, and so I wanted to talk to you about more from this week's selection, Love is a Choice, which was a huge help to me on my recovery journey. So as you guys begin to come in, feel free to invite some others to join you, to share out the video. Certainly, if you are coming in for the very, very first time and don't know who I am, my name is Marcy Batiste. I'm a public speaker, I'm an author, and I am a success and recovery trainer. I have a company called Bankable Success Advisors, specializing in working with people, individuals, and businesses to help them actually optimize their personal investments and their professional investments, whether it's your time, your energy, your emotions. Hey, Christopher, thanks for joining in. Whatever that looks like, whatever we're making that investment in to teach people how to get the most bang for their buck. What's up, DJ Outlaw? And so I'm known for a couple of things. So number one, I'm always living life on Mars. That means I operate from a space of my world, my life, my rules. Not in a bad perspective, but just a real space that says if it's good, I do what's good for me first, and I don't feel guilty about that. Second of all, I'm sold out to my happiness, and so that's sort of my beacon. That's my North Star. That's my true north, and I use that as my barometer to measure if what I'm doing is the right thing for me or not. And again, unapologetically. And the third thing is my passion for helping women be able to do the same things, helping them discover and truly fully embrace what I call their star power. And once they're able to do that, and they really realize what these pillars of star power mean, then they're equipped to go out and ignite the light for someone else. And so this year meant a mission, really, to work with 1,000 women to help them do just that, discover and embrace their star power. And so 30 Books in 30 Weeks is just one part of that. It was a way to challenge myself, raise the bar for myself, to make me get back to my own personal development. But then also I decided, you know, it'd be a good time to just do a little refresher and be able to share some of these critical takeaways and these critical ahas with you all. And so we started this last year and we're carrying it on for the first 30 weeks of this year, and we are already in week 12. Love is a Choice is the reading selection for this week. So I was just out here doing my reading, and so the message today from the book and from my own experience, as I said, I'm a success and recovery trainer, but reality-based success and recovery trainer. So I always like to operate in the lane of keeping things very, very realistic. I want to be in harmony with what is reality. I don't want to be off in some la-la land thinking that I'm living a life that I'm not living. I want to be honest about my relationships, personal and professional. So I was thinking about what would be a goal for a relationship, something that's easy for us to kind of understand, for us to resonate with. And I decided that interdependent love would be the relationship goal. A few weeks ago, I did a series on codependency, and so we spent an entire week talking about what codependency looks like. And I think we sometimes have an idea of codependency, but we have no idea what interdependency looks like. And understanding how to operate with reality in an interdependent space. And so when we think of interdependent relationships, I want you to think about a figure skating team, right? So the Winter Olympics just got over a few weeks ago, and that's one of the things that I love to watch on there is the figure skaters. And when you look at them, they are an interdependent operation, which means they will still rely on one another, but they separate when necessary, and then they return and come back together for one common goal. They always stay in synchronicity. They stay synchronized, basically. So they're always in sync. He knows when she's gonna do this, and she knows when he's gonna do that. And if it means they're conjoined at the neck, if it's by one leg, one arm, whatever. And there's this trust, this innate trust in the figure skating sport. You have to really trust your partner to be able to have them fling you across the rink at 20 or 30 miles an hour. I don't know how fast they're going, but it looks like it's really fast. It's high speed, high energy, right? That's what I think the ultimate relationship should look like. Not that it has to go at high speed all the time, but that you have that trust that it's okay to separate for a while and let's come back together. In other words, you know, let each person have their own independent life. Let them have their own time with their own friends. Let them have their own hobbies, their own interests, all those things. Everything doesn't have to be like this for the relationship to be strong. Sometimes the relationship can be like this, and that's how you build the house, right? Knowing when to lean on one another and when to be able to allow each other your own space. And so that interdependent love, if I had to pick a relationship goal, that's what it would be. Someone that I can have great communication with, someone that I know is going to have my back, but also that's going to give me the honest truth, not truth from a perspective of what they're afraid of losing, or truth out of what they have to gain or to lose from it, but really what it is that is going to make the unit stronger. And when you think of it as a unit, as a partnership, to me, that's relationship goals, that's interdependency. And so then I was thinking, like, what are some characteristics? Like, how do you know whether you have, so you've got independent, which you're out operating all on your own without regard to the other relationship, with the relationship, although you're in one. And then you have codependency, which is like locked down onto each other. And so interdependent allows enough space for you to navigate, for you to be an independent individual person, but still build strength from the union. And so I was thinking, you know, what are some differences? So like an interdependent relationship, you have a desire to be together, but you don't feel compelled that you have to be together 24 hours a day or something like that. So it allows, again, it allows that space. It allows that choice. It allows you to choose the relationship over feeling compelled to be in it, like feeling like you can't survive without the relationship. The other thing is for an interdependent relationship allows each person, like I said, to have their own identity. Like, you have your identity built off of your own interests and your own experiences. Not your identity is not derived from the fact that you're in this relationship. Oh, I'm so-and-so's. And I know years ago that was the big thing. Like, women actually not only gave up their last name, but essentially gave up their first names because they were like, I just became Mrs. John Smith, and I no longer was Mary Smith, right? And so that to me is one of the things that progression has allowed us to still have our own identity. I can be Mary Smith, I can be Marcy Batiste. I don't have to just be Mrs. Joe Smith, right? I can be me, and I can choose to be me without there being any feeling of threat to the unity, to the unit. Strength in reality versus the illusion of strength, right? Like I said, I'm a reality-based trainer, so to me, always operating in that vein of what does reality say, what is reality telling us, and to be able to take those gut checks periodically and say, where are we really? Let's bring this back to the table. How do you feel? Are you happy? Are you comfortable? Do you feel secure? Do you feel safe? And understanding where the other person comes from versus the illusion of strength, where you say, oh, I'm in this relationship, so I'm strong because of it. And some people really derive their identity from the fact that they're in a relationship and they're not very comfortable operating from the space of being single. Consistent versus dramatic. I know, like, some of my most toxic relationships, they were always highly charged. Everything was extra. Everything was dramatic. It was extra exciting. It was extra everything. versus just that consistency, that person that you can rely on to be there. You don't ever have to question like loyalty. You don't have to question the respect. You don't have to question the commitment. Interdependent, right? Gives you that space to move around. Someone that's going to provide you a broad base of support, not just a narrow focus. That narrow focus keeps you the same. It keeps you from changing. It keeps you from being able to become versus someone who's going to support you in a broad fashion, allows you to be who you want to be, allows you room to grow, allows you to become. One of the things I always say, when you want different, you have to do different. An interdependent relationship builds on your ability, each partner's ability to be different, to grow, to exercise, to try some things out. Hey, Gregory. And then that, I think that in an interdependent relationship, you have each person has a willingness to surrender. So it's not one person trying to control the other. It's not one person trying to drive the context of the relationship, but you really have both parties being able to surrender to the unit and say, you know what, the relationship is a choice. The love is a choice. I'm gonna choose this every single day. I'm going to choose to remain committed to the growth. I'm going to choose to continue to better myself because I know that bettering me, when I get better, the relationship gets better. And when you have a codependent relationship, it's a very narrow focus. Like if anything shifts, if anything changes, one or both of the parties becomes fearful. It's very threatening. It's very intimidating. So to me, when I like I said, I was reading, doing my reading for today, and that was the thought that I had, was that if I had to sum up what would be a relationship goal for me, how would I best describe it? That's how I would describe it. Interdependent. Not dependent, not independent, not codependent. Interdependent, where it's a partnership, where you're truly relying on one another. You've got the synchronicity of the figure skaters, but you have the excellence in execution of each person individually. All right. So that's the message for today. I hope that it helps. I hope that you it makes you think a little bit. And then just a reminder for those of you who are interested in 60 Days Laser Coaching, the new session starts April 19th. There's a link up in the bio. And so make sure that you check it out. If you have questions about it, feel free to reach out. We'll talk about the pillars of star power and really truly, like I said, helping women embrace their own star power that already resides within them so they can go out and ignite the light for somebody else. So that's the word today. As always, guys, I appreciate you so much. Thank you for stopping in. Hey, Jen. Hey, Howard. Trisha. So as always, thanks for joining in. Thanks for the support. And most of all, thanks for living life on Mars with me, guys. Have a great day. We'll talk soon.